I have this beautiful collection of diodes I bought from China, but I'm not sure about the parameters, so I decided to test it. So, what can I test? There are a few things. Obviously, first is the breakthrough voltage. It's not really important, and it can be easily tested if you have the variable voltage source. A high voltage source might be a couple of hundred volts. And current limiting resistor, say 1 mega ohm, we can detect at which voltage we have the breakthrough. So we can measure with the voltmeter. So the second thing is the maximum current. Again, we have to have the power supply with where I can control the current, and then I can see at what current actually I have a magical smoke coming from this device. So the last parameter is probably the most important for me, is speed. So what can I do? I can take this diode and I can try to charge it with the small current, charge the pin junction capacitance. So the speed is limited by the capacitance on the pin junction. So I can try to charge it with very small current and then measure the time when the charge is complete. So I use high pulses, submit the pulses to the capacitor, to the diode through the resistor, and see the waveform. And I can measure this this time, and then I can estimate the RC from the RC constant, so multiplying the resistor value by the capacitance, unknown capacitance, we will get the time constant. But we know the time constant, so we can derive the capacitance. But before we do this, we have to test the probe. So I have the oscilloscope, and I have the oscilloscope probe. And this probe has the internal parasitic capacitance. So I would like to make sure that it's not going to affect my measurements. So for the detection of small capacitance, I have to use big resistance. However, this resistance is limited by the parasitic capacitance of the probe. So what I can do, I can submit the pulses to the resistor and then connect it to the probe and see what is going to happen. So actually, I'm observing those types of graphs. For the high value resistance, let's say R equal to 100 kilo ohms, I will see this. They actually have the graphs for the probe. So I did those measurements. So this is the pure generator pulses when the resistance is infinite, actually when there is no resistance, so it's cutting directly. So the resistance is zero. Then I connect the probe to the generator through the resistance R 100 kilo ohm, and we see that it's not no longer square pulses. It's not good. The same is true for 10k. Like I have small those small rounded corners, and 5k. Well, I have to probably stop at this one because I cannot go any longer. Because otherwise, I will not be able to test anything. So let's assume I'm going to have R equal 5.1 kilo ohm. So in that case, I have this resistor connected to the generator and connected to the probe of the oscilloscope, and I have almost square pulses. Now I can connect the diodes to the circuit. So the first thing I can measure, I can connect the diode in this way. So I have a resistor, and then the diode goes to the ground, and then I can measure the voltage on this diode. So those types of measurements are not actually very interesting because I'm not going to see much. I just see the voltage at which this diode is open. But that's it. The next one is actually what I need. So I connect the resistor to the ground, so in that case just flip those. So resistor goes to the ground, and I submit the generator pulses to this circuit, simple circuit. So what happens in that case? I have the current flowing through the resistor, and I can measure this current by looking at the voltage on the resistor. So I'm looking at the current surges. So assuming that this diode has the internal parasitic capacitance, this capacitance is going to be charged when the pulses are arriving. That's why I'm going to have the surge in the current peak. So in that case, I have the pulse coming, and then boom, I have the current surge, the current peak, and then when the current drops, when the capacitor is discharging, so I have the peak again. So that's what I'm expecting to see. So once I am serving those types of graphs, I can measure the time. So this time, and then from the time I will time which is equal to RC, from where I can derive the C, which is time divided by R. And that's where I can measure the capacitance of the p-n junction. Okay, let's go to the lab. Boom, boom, boom. So here is the simple circuit. So we have the resistor connected to the ground. We have the diode. We have the generator connected to the input. And we have the probe, which is looking at the voltage across this resistor. Basically, looking at the current flowing through the resistor. Because the value of the resistor is known, we can compute the current if you need. And here is the results. So the yellow one is the voltage across the resistor, which is proportional to the current. The blue one is the generator signal. And I have done measurements for the several types of diodes. So like they have those two, I have the power diode, and so on. Well, actually, this is not the power diode, it's just the regular diode. It's not ultra fast, just the usual one. And here is the graph I have. So the first two graphs are the baseline. So I have bipolar pulses with plus and minus approximately 1 volt. Then I have the measurement of voltage across this diode. So I'm using this circuit. So that it goes to the ground, and then I have the resistor. I'm looking at the voltage across this diode. So I can detect the voltage at which the diode is open. So I'm using, in this case, two different types of diodes. So D814 and ultrafast 4007. So, okay, another defined part is the current across the diode. So I see those surges, the oscilloscope. I see those surges of the current. From where I can try to measure the relaxation time. So basically tau, time constant, which is R multiplied by C. And so this one is the usual diode, and this is the ultrafast. And we note right away that the differences are quite significant. So we have very small surges, peaks for the ultrafast, and quite significant for the usual type of diode. And then I'm looking at this graph, so I just zoom in ultrafast, and I see that, yes, I can probably measure the relaxation time, in this case 2 microseconds. Unfortunately, it's not very well detected. So I can conclude that my probes have too large capacitance. So I'm limited with the resistance. So if you go back. So I cannot go with high resistance. So in that case, I'm going to have those types of graphs which are not actual square pulses. So I'm limited to the resistor, which is 5 kilo ohm approximately, and because of that I cannot extend this relaxation time, and the measurements are pretty rough. It's good measurement for the usual type of diode, but if we go into the ultra fast one, I cannot measure this one correctly. But anyways, let's plug the numbers. So I plugged the number and I got the result, 400 picofarad. Probably is 10 times less, or maybe more, or probably less. Anyways, so those are the results. And here is the reference power diode. I took the power bridge and measured one of the diodes. So we have very nice surges of current. So that's why if you build a power supply, the good idea would be to put a capacitance in series with the diode so that you can negate those pulses. Okay, so that's it.